Alright, sorry about that. Now, let's do this. Alright, so we just finished the forest naval. Let's go back here. And farm some stuff for blue. Day 10, Mamuda. Pretty easy. I could just take out all blues. Die. Look at his soulless eyes in this texture remake. Nah, it doesn't work yet. The effort is fine. You have not made that discovery, that's happened multiple times. Oh yeah, I need a couple of yellows. Mm. Wasn't paying attention. That's all I needed you guys for. Yeah, I guess this is a bit overkill for this part. Yeah. Ah, 50 can lift that thing. Oh, come on, what? There we go. That was a good one. Oh, what? Get out of there! What the hell, man? Okay, you guys just deserve that. I called you. Thank you. I had a feeling there's a blue over there. Eh, forget it. Man, where'd the day go? Okay, that's annoying. What the hell? Why do they not come back sometimes? What the frick? God damn it! You suicidal morons? Doing any damage now. That was a good one. Barely did anything. I don't care. There we go. Oh. Well, okay. Looks like I might have to spend a second day here. Yeah, there's no way I can pick these all. Damn it. Just in time. Positron generator. This electric generator was a pain in the ass to get out of the shell. If you approach it carelessly, you'll get an electric shock. I've now recovered a little over half. No, you freaking. God damn it. They're so annoying in Pikmin 1. I'm so glad they make him not as stupid in Pikmin 2. The fact that they attack and like get distracted by everything when they're in your squad in this game is so annoying. How many got left behind? Two. Okay, that's fine. That's their fault. I don't know, man. I really didn't like how that day went. Oh well. Those sprouted Pikmin are never gonna get plucked. I'll have to pluck themselves. I have plenty of Pikmin anyways. I never even built that bridge in the first place, so... Alright. How do you get hurt? Oh yeah, I punched him, I think. Love those bongos. These Pikmin need Adderall. Hey, you bastard. All done with the blues on this level. Okay. Okay. Found my Sagittarius. My son gave this to me as a present. It brings to mind visions of my son back home on planet Hokote. Oh, to be back there right now. Really? Cut. Pikmin are really incompetent. Was a gift for my son. He must be very worried about me. There we go. At last, my radiation canopy. This turns the harsh radiation of deep space into soft infrared rays that are easy on the body. I'll sleep like a baby once I get this back to the ship. Might as well carry this guy back too. Ah, 30. Forget it. Oh yeah, these guys. These guys. Swarm! Sliding after he died. Okay. I have to go get that one moron. Radiation canopy. I'll have to inspect it later to make sure it hasn't cracked. I'll be in for even more trouble if I have any radiation leaks. Yep, he did. Come on, trigger hit. There it is. Get him. Yeah, he did. There we go. It's the Geiger counter. Every spaceship needs one of these, but I don't actually know what it's for. Every once in a while it goes wild and lets out a lot of noise, but I never pay much attention to it, so it doesn't do me much good. I really should read that manual one of these. Yeah, you should. You know, it only means you're being blasted with cancerous radiation, but whatever. Oh, sure, guys, go the totally long way with all the enemies on the route instead of just going down the cliff right there. Ugh. He's Pikmin. There he is. Alright, come on. Not much time left. bump into him. Okay. No, I don't think we're gonna make it. Damn. Just barely not enough time. Well. Alright. Where's the one loner? Oh, he's over there. Okay, that's fine. What a shame. One trip. That's great. I don't think I've ever seen that at this part. Hope has begun to well up within me for the dolphin's repair and my own chances for a reunion with my dear family. Tomorrow I shall go forth with a new attitude and continue my exploration in a different region, except I'm not. I hope that fortune will smile upon me. Stupid Pikmin. They always take the long route around. I'm spending an entire day just to bring that one little part back. Might as well slaughter everything else too. Thanks, asshole. Well, one Pikmin took all the sap. Tiger counter. This noisy gauge is always letting off spontaneous clicks and buzzes. I probably have tons of radiation poisoning. It can be kind of annoying. Let's see if it's enough to kill this guy without too many casualties. I don't have good hopes for this one. Oh, alrighty then. Oh, Let me forget it. Come on, dude. You duck. Really? One actually died. Two actually died. Okay, well, they deserved it. Survival of the fittest. Oh, screw you. Don't wake up the big one. All right. There's nothing over here, right? I think I killed them all. Yep, killed them all. Excuse me. Thank you. Let's see. I think these guys are all flowers now, so. I'll just get more things. How'd that happen? And you guys go fishing. And you guys are fast. Hey, what's up, dude? I think I'm missing one somewhere. Ugh, figures. Can't wait till I get to Pikmin 2. How do you get stuck in there? How you doing, Cyber? That's right, no food for you. Well, days since impact. It's very strange. The scenery of this planet, which I once found hostile, now sometimes strikes me as surprisingly serene. Perhaps the Pikmin have opened my heart to the beauty of this world. I even started thinking there were some parts I do not need. A daydream. Nice, that was a good growth. 390 red. Okay, now to the hardest, most annoying level of the game. And day 13, so I could still fight that cursed boss. Just a moment. Music in this is so calm, and yet such a crazy, dangerous level. Let's start off with the blues. I'm gonna fight that crazy thing. I need to use that strat. Yeah, wait, frogs. Not time for you. The egg. Woo! Close one. Oh, what? Why does he have full health? You're supposed to get the egg down. What? Did I not understand the strategy? I understood you're supposed to get the egg down to red, and then when he breaks out, he'll be red. Get out of here. I'm typing. I don't have time for your crap. That's right. Alright, come on. almost spent 30 killing him so far, so it wouldn't be that great of a reward. Well, where are we going? Yeah, okay. There's not supposed to be a bull bear right here, what? Hmm. No! Frick. Really? Not dead yet? There we go. Alright. Net gain, because he didn't kill too many of them. Alright, who do I have the least of? At least a yellow, but it's still way more than I'll need for, like, the rest of the game. I don't know, it's really down to blues or reds. I mean, I have a lot of both. Definitely gonna need a lot of blues. I don't know if I'll need that many blues. Yeah, I'll just give it to red. Precious gold, disgusting looking pearl. Alright. Woo! You don't stop making that discovery. You keep forgetting you've made it every time. Over here. Come here. No, 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 no. There we go. There we go. Picking these. Alright. I don't like how their spots like grow like that, it's gross. Woo! Take that. Thank you. Well, they fell in an unfortunate direction. Whoa. Oh, preemptive there, don't you think? Okay. Sliding into the water. Did it only give me 3? Oh, it was a 5 block. It wasn't a frog. Okay, they give you 8. It's alright, I guess. Not really worth killing them. Thank you. Huh, got lucky with this one. No, get out of here. Forget it. There appears to be a large cluster of parts here. My calculations are correct, and I should be able to recover virtually all of my missing ship parts. But not quite all of them, unfortunately. There still seem to be some pieces that remain unaccounted for. Must find 10 more parts. Nice. Over 1,000 Pikmin sprouted total. Come on, guys, really? Oh, they picked those up out of nowhere. Attack! Really, guys? Found my massage machine. Put this right down in the lower back area and let it go to work. I can't wait till I get it installed again. My lower lumbar region has been paining me ever since the crash. Ah, sweet relief. Oh wait, right. Crap, save them. Yeah, like our bros. No, I didn't want to do that. I'm in the cutscene. Massage machine. I've been walking so much lately. I'm really looking forward to using this. I have now recovered 20 out of 30 parts. If I could just find 9 more, I'll be able to increase my ship's capabilities. Where else is there, bomb rocks? Right over there, I think. Back here. Oh. That's it? It's only four? I still need one more bomb rock. Alright. See if I have any leaves or buds here. It's weird that the battle music plays when you're drinking sap. Huh. Kinda reminds me of the Wind Waker battle music, like on a Forsaken Fortress. Hmm. Oops. Aha, you go hungry. Days since impact. I have seen that, at times, the leaf atop a Pikmin's head will grow into a bud, and then a flower. It appears that if I do not pick the Pikmin's sprouts, they gradually bloom over time. Fascinating! This melding of plant and animal traits is surely unique in the natural world. I have found the increased swiftness of the flower Pikmin to be of tremendous benefit. Also, my diligent observation has recorded instances in which flower Pikmin lost in battle have left seeds behind. This is why on days after fierce battles, I occasionally find new sprouts growing. Those things are annoying. They died in unison. Get out of here. Oh! No, get out of here! Ah! Really, dude? That's your fault for tripping. Stop hiding behind those dimples, you coward. Wrong. Where are they going that way? They're going the opposite way of the ship. Oh, whatever. Why are they dying? God damn it, there's a couple more I didn't see. Interstellar radio. This part will send out a daily SOS signal. I have so little time remaining, though, that I have no option but to continue my search rather than waiting for a rescue party. Having to collect every part is a bit overwhelming, but I get the impression not all parts are needed to fly the ship. Thank you. 1,000 exactly. Oh, they're in the ground. Alright. Oh, there's more bomb rocks right there too. Don't need them though. Thank you. Ah, what the frick? Okay, that is some seriously stupid AI. They deserve to die if they keep getting distracted like that. You literally cannot call them back from building that bridge. Yeah. Left behind one, my ass. I found the gluon drive. Using the quark-binding metaphysical properties of gluons, this device, well, it's very scientific, and I don't fully understand it myself, but it was very expensive. That's how you know its quality. Perfect. Alright, what else is there? Alright. Mm-hmm. Luan Drive. I have no idea how this works, but it means the dolphin will again lift off with its characteristic roar. I'll just keep him out right there. What? They haven't even done one level. One had to sacrifice himself. So annoying. Really, dude? Fucking really? You fucking moron. God damn it. That is why yellow Pikmin will always remain my least favorite. I also hate how in this one your Pikmin can't keep up with you, so you can't run and throw. Unless you're like holding down the C-stick when you're bear clawing it. It's like they're all headbanging. And which way will you go if you carry this stuff? The wrong way. Alright. Thank you. When I see the Pikmin engaged in fierce battle with the other creatures of this world, I often grow uneasy, wondering why they never attack me. Could it be that they actually view me as a parental figure? Strange, disturbing thought. Murder time. That's not fair. Oh, just a split second before they die. Nice. Only one death, not bad. Nice. Then. Oof. One more died again. Oh well. Okay. Fuck. Discovered the bowsprit. With this piece installed, my ship should regain some of its sleek shape. Oh, not enough. think that's most of the enemies in this level, so that's good. The rest of this should be a breeze now. I have plenty of Pikmin too, so I don't really need to collect anything, but why not? My analog sticks is not calibrated correctly. I'm pushing directly up right now, and it's going like up left. Oh, that's weird. It's the Z. The top-down view makes you go, like, left for some reason? Spirit, the so-called face of the dolphin. In point of the fact, I designed it. Neat. Oh, they give you a lot. Kind of annoying how he's floating over that little puddle. Nice. Thank you. know, this game's not nearly as hard as I remember it being as a kid, but that makes perfect sense. It was just so intimidating as a kid. Seeing the Pikmin die is so heartbreaking. And now I'm so frustrated with them, it's not as bad seeing them die. Oh, that's a bad... Alright, wait, why am I throwing them down there? I don't know. Probably need yellow for this, don't I? Yeah, definitely need yellow for this. Let's see, what else can I get without blue? Yeah, I think I need blue for all of the rest of them. Except for this one, which I need yellow. Ugh. Oh, what the- These Pikmin are so stupid. Repair type bolt. This robotic marvel can fix just about anything the ship is broken. It's good because I got terribly bored fixing little glitches. Okay. Dumb little bastards. Candy pop bud. When I throw Pikmin in this flower, they are popped right back out. I have named this very peculiar bloom the candy pop bud. It's strange. No matter what color Pikmin I throw in, the ones that pop out match the flower's color. Strange. Repair type bolt. This looks like an ordinary bolt, but it is actually a repair robot. Neat. And they trip a lot. That guy's back. Nice. Nothing too harmful over here. Nope. That background's kinda cool looking. Oh, that looks heavy, so I'll probably need a lot. Sure, just most of them fall off. God damn it. Number 2 Ionian jet. The ads for these jets boast that with excellent mileage that's easy on the family budget, this jet will keep your wife smiling and propel you to a happy home life. Need lifeguard bros. Right here. Huh. All right. Found my Kronos reactor. Using strange new technology, this machine is able to warp the space-time continuum and turn it into energy. I'm constantly amazed at how many mysteries are locked inside the parts of my ship. Alright, cool. That's all I need you guys to do. I'll become blue. My Pikmin now. This asshole. Thank you. Chronos Reactor. This reactor changes permutations in the space-time continuum into pure energy. Basically, it's like a big rubber band, but not at all. It's like a balloon with too much air. Last, my pilot seat. Once I get this installed, my cockpit will finally be back in order. Soon, my ship will be starting to look more and more like the dolphin of old. Ah, the memories. Really? It takes that many? I don't look that heavy. It's my zirconium rotor. This is made from rust poof. Proof zirconium, which is particularly suited to making spaceship parts. I had to pay a lot extra to have this installed, and I suspect the mechanic overcharged me. Yeah, probably. Zirconium rotor, made of rust-proof zirconium. It is as shiny as new, despite being left out on this planet's harsh elements. Neat. Thank you. Well, you need to spend a whole day to get one part now. Still though, not too bad on the time. I'll probably beat the game in 21 days. Pilot seat. Picturing this in the cockpit, images of me lifting off into space begin to fill my taxed brain. It fills me with inspiration once again. I have now received 28 out of 30 parts. Alright. No food for you. Days since impact. If I could just find two more parts, the Dolphin will be fully rebuilt. But time has grown short. I must not flag in my search. Even if I cannot recover every piece, I will not give up. Surely some of those parts aren't absolutely necessary. I can almost see my smiling family. Last part of this area. Can I walk with this? Oh, I can. Ah. Nice. How'd they get out of there? Huh. I found my UV lamp. The only problem with this handheld light is that it can be too bright at times. I have to remember to wear my sun visor whenever I look into it. UV lamp? Doesn't sound healthy. UV lamp. This handy light is great for tanning, but it doesn't seem to have any relation to the Dolphin's flight capabilities. I doubt that it will affect my escape from this planet. Perhaps there are other parts like this as well. Oh. Well, I think I pretty much already at least won the game for basic, good ending. Yeah, you do that. kill some fishies. You can do it. I believe in you. Any day now. Why Sap does the battle music? Alright. Done with this level. All that's left is the last one. Last, but a single part remains. Since I've recovered 29 of the missing parts, the dolphin's power is near capacity. In the forest depths below, I see a region where the final part must lie. Clearly, this is my final trial. My life support fails in 11 days. Courage. Trial. Let's do it. Ba da da ba 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 da ba. I like this waltz. That's cool, they give you candy pot buds in case you have too much of one and not enough of another. Love this soundtrack because it's cheery and hopeful, but it has a very, like, sinister undertone to it. So, I don't know music, I don't know if there's like a minor key to it. Nope, nope, nope. Frick. I was on the wrong side. Why is the fire so loud in this level? Yeah, that works, I guess. Okay. Lifeguard Bros. That's annoying. Frick. Well, oh no, it got rid of the bomb rocks though. Well. Okay, lifeguard bros, you seriously failed your job here. Alright. Well. That went horribly. Their lost causes. Guys, they're right there. Well, I have two bomb rocks, so I just wasted a day. Try that again. I'm a dingus. We're supposed to go around. Oh, I can walk up here like that? Ah, fuck! God damn it. So glad they got rid of bomb rock mechanics in the sequels.
Thank you.
Perfect. 6 bombs. Oh, and I only need 3 for this one. At least they're nice enough to make a weak wall. Oh, really? Well then. I have more than half a day for the final boss now. Alright, let's do this. There you go, that's the one I want. Oh, where'd the bomb guy go? Okay. Bomb guy. There we go. Your sacrifice was not in vain. Oh, that's cool. Oh, you idiot. He made his tongue smack him in the face. That's cool. You gonna throw that bomb dude? Where'd bomb dude go? What the hell? And I don't know if I'll beat him by time runs out. What the fuck was that? It threw it right in his mouth. Beating him before time runs out. That's crap. I don't want any of you. I want the bomb guys. God. Why do the bombs barely do anything? Well, that sucked. I wanted you to guys to drop the bombs. Ow, that scared the crap out of me and hurt my ears. Holy crap, ow. Come on, dude. There we go. Okay. I want that yellow. What? Come on. Okay. Why are they falling? What the fuck? Yes, sir. Go away. That's their fault. Finally, your shit got old real fast, my old man. Long last, I found the final part, my secret stave. And it's full as ever. How glad am I that I persisted in my search without losing hope. Now I can leave this planet without any regrets. Maybe I'll even stop and pick up some souvenirs for my wife and kids back on planet Hokuto. Ta-da! I have finally recovered every ship part. Now I can return home to Hokuto. Bye. So cute! Aha! They can jump now. Jump and attack by themselves. Look at all the Pikmin onions. There's orange, pink, black, turquoise, blue, light green. Goodbye, blue planet that had man-made things on it. Days, not bad. Probably a new record for me, honestly. 455 lost, 986 remain. Total Pikmin ever sprouted, 1,441. Ship parts recovered, all of them. Hiroshi Yamauchi, you're a pretty clever son of a bitch. Rich Amtower. Leslie Swan? What does she have to do in this game? She's the voice of Peach. I wonder if she was the Pikmin too. Some of the enemies or something. Dan Simpson. Cam Wu. Andy Beecraft. Jim Holdeman. Super Mario Club.
All rights, including copyrights, the game, scenario, music, and program, reserved by Nintendo.
These are pre-rendered videos. Armored cannon beetle. These migrant with a pod have developed a stronger carapace than its relatives. Beady longlegs. Waxy secretions form this creature's distinctive armored shell. Yeah, get wrecked. Redbug. This creature's thick hide protects it from most attackers. Dish islands. Burrowing snagret. The bluish hue of its feathers distinguishes it from the burrowing snarrow. Burrowing snarrow? I wonder if that was the enemy that got cut from this game but they included in the second one. Candy Pop Bud. Could this be the next step in Pikmin evolution? Like the Pikmin themselves, it has many mysteries. Dwarf Bull Bear. A bull bear at an early stage of development in its life cycle. This specimen appears to be nearly fully developed. Dwarf Bulborb. Although similar in appearance to bulborbs, these belong to a totally different species. A mimic species. Emperor Bulblax. This massive grub dog burrows itself in when hunting. Fiery Blowhog. This creature expels a combustible phosphor that ignites at moderate temperatures. Swooping Snitchbug. This rare species uses its antenna as wings. It doesn't spawn there. Ulix. A watery gelatinous membrane protects this creature's nervous system. There's also like a dwarf bulborbs and stuff. Very early demo release. Not really release. Honey Wisp. This creature collects nectar for the larvae waiting in its nest. Must be like early demo footage. Iridescent Flint Beetle. This forager stores undigested pellets in its stomach for winter. Mamuda. Has the same markings on its arms. Oh, that's different. As the onions. This creature seems fond of flowers, but only for their decorative properties. Pearly Clam Clamp. Though beautiful, this mollusk's pearls are thin and fragile. Pellet Posy. This sparsely growing plant is able to crystallize nectar into round pellets, with numbers on them. Puff Stool. Many consider this walking fungus a delicacy. How can many consider that if you've been the only one on this planet? Puffy Blowhog. Instead of breathing fire, this species uses its hydrogen to float. And be annoying. Sheer Grub. Males of this species are purple and have an armored head, and kill Pikmin by eating them. Females do not have the necessary mouths to do so. Sheer Wig. The males of the species are able to fly, but the females remain underground. The males are also really annoying. Smoky Prog. Thought to be the next step of metal and rock. Spawny Bulbear. This rare subspecies of bulborb has a certain indefatigability. Oh wow, they're a lot smaller in the demo. With bigger eyes. Spotty Bulborb. This nocturnal hunter feeds mostly on small animals returning to their nests at night. Wow. Opportunistic bastard. Water Dumple. This aquatic creature is a close relative of Bulborb. Interesting. Wogpole. This creature appears to be a newborn yellow Wallywog in tadpole form. Yes, kill them while they're small. Wallywog. This creature's coloration results from remaining sheltered in its cavernous dwelling. Yellow Wallywog. After evolution led to the development of its specialized jumping ability, this amphibian actually lost much of its ability to swim. The end. The happy end. Happy the end, Nintendo. They stopped moving. What a great and at times infuriating game. What's this? The single day challenge mode. How many Pikmin can you grow in a day? High scores. Neat. Fun stuff, fun stuff. Well, that was Pikmin 1. Alright, well, thanks for checking out the stream. It was really fun. I finally got to 100% this game after many years. A lot easier than I remember, but also a lot more infuriating than I remember. The Pikmin certainly aren't the brightest little things. Definitely gonna have more fun with Pikmin 2, though. I love that game. No time limits, you don't have to stress and hurry with things. The Pikmin are smarter, and the mechanics are more refined. No annoying, bomb rock carrying Pikmin. So, you don't have to worry about those mechanics anymore either. And there's more Pikmin too in the sequel. Once again, I'd like to thank you for checking out the stream, and I hope you had a good time. I know I did. I hope you have a pleasant afternoon, night, morning, wherever you are, whatever you're doing. Have a good one. Thanks.